So Arleen Spenceley, thank you so much for being here with us and really being a part of our campaign called Unhooked, Holy in a Hookup World. So you decided to go public with your choice to stay abstinent?
Yeah, you could say that.
Okay, so tell me about that.
So yeah, when I was 23, I had just started working for the Tampa Bay Times, which is Florida's largest newspaper. And pretty early on in that time of my life, I had started dating a guy who did not define sex the same way I do. He was not a Christian like I am, and back then I had a different set of standards. I didn't really think much about whether I should share values with the guy I date. I just thought, hey, he's cute. Let's see if it will work, you know? And the further we got into our relationship, the clearer it became to me that he was not okay with saving sex for marriage, and that had been my plan. So I ended up ending this relationship, and afterward I realized that if this one random guy that I happen to date doesn't understand why I'm saving sex, then probably a bunch of other people on this planet don't understand that decision either. And so I decided, you know what, I work for the largest newspaper in the state. I'm going to take advantage of that and tell people what this is all about. And wow. So I wrote this essay, Why I'm Still a Virgin at Age 23. The feedback that I got was nothing that I even ever anticipated. But as it turned out, people really needed to talk about the virtue of chastity. So if chastity is a virtue, then it's a decision you make every day over and over to do the right thing regarding sex. Because all of us, single or married, are called to do the right thing regarding sex. And as a single person, part of that is abstinence because of what I believe sex is. Sex is a sacred physical sign of the vows that a husband and wife took on the altar where they were married. It's the expression of the unity that is actually achieved by matrimony. And so if I'm not married, then sex is simply not for me.
So how do you think someone who maybe has had a past that isn't pure, how can they start being abstinent and really unhooking themselves from the hookup world?
Yeah, so that's the beauty of the virtue of chastity. You can start today. It's not necessary to have always been chaste in the past. You can start practicing that virtue now. And there are some different things that I would recommend to people who are new to this way of life. And, you know, one of them is to surround yourself with a community of people who can support you in this. Do not vent about it to friends who don't practice it. You want instead to vent about it to friends who are better at it than you are, because they're going to be able to help you to get through what you're going through when it's difficult. You know, sometimes you see a person you're interested in, and you don't know anything about them, and you begin to pursue this relationship, and very quickly it becomes clear to you, this person doesn't love Jesus the way I do, this person doesn't have the same values that I do. The problem is, we haven't thought critically, because we're entering these relationships without ever asking important questions like, does this relationship help or hurt my relationship with Christ? Does this relationship make meeting my goals easier as a Christian, or does it make meeting my goals more difficult? And if we start to think critically and ask those questions, we start to discern more clearly whether we should or shouldn't enter certain relationships.
So does practicing chastity make dating more difficult?
Yeah.
How does it make it more difficult? And if it does make dating more difficult, where is the hope?
It makes the pool of people you can pick from much, much smaller. And so sometimes it takes a lot longer to meet someone who meets your standards. And that, I think, is where a lot of people start to lose hope. People start to think, I'm never going to meet somebody who believes what I do, who loves Jesus like I do, who can live the kind of life I would want to live with them. And so they begin to lower their standards and they begin to settle for relationships that are not as healthy or as holy as God would want for them. And so, yes, like sexual desire will arise in us and it's important to listen to it and to say, hey, like I find myself attracted to this person. Is this something I should act on? Could this be the person that God wants me to marry in the end? But sometimes in our culture, and by sometimes I mean 98.9% of the time, people misuse sexual desire. They don't see it as a reason to turn toward somebody else and will their good. They see it as an opportunity to will their own good by using somebody else to satisfy those desires. But you know, there is hope, and through the grace of God, it is possible to practice chastity, and I'm living proof of that.
Well, Arleen, thank you. Seriously, thank you so much for just allowing me to talk to you. I know your words of advice are going to touch a lot of people, so thank you.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.